Before the Sacramento Bee dubbed him the Whale, he was just Charlie Walker, a 6'2 sophomore all-league center from McClatchy High School. He was all-league again for McClatchy as a junior. Prior to his senior year, Charlie transferred to Sacramento High School, and at 6'5", 200 pounds, he was nicknamed the Whale as he led the Dragons through an undefeated 22-0 regular season. Then a February graduation cost the Dragons a key player, and Sac High had to play in the Tournament of Champions without him. The Dragons managed to win their first round game as Charlie led them with 18 points. But the win streak ended at 23, and the Dragons finished in fourth place. Charlie, who scored another 18 points in the third place game, was named to the all-tournament team. After graduation, Charles enrolled at Sac City, where he led the Panthers to the best season of Coach Jerry Anderson's tenure. The Panthers went 30-10 and finished in third place in the conference. Charles became the first Panther to average over 20 points a game. He averaged 21.8. His 632 total points and three 30-point games were school records as well. He was a rebounding machine, with a single-game high of 29, which remains the school record to this day. Charles was all-tournament twice during the season and ended the season being named first-team all-league. Charles accepted a scholarship to Utah State, where he played in the first 10 games of the season, averaging 9 points and almost 10 rebounds. But unfortunately, he had to return home at the end of the quarter. Through much of the 1960s, Charles played semi-pro basketball for Mike Salta Pontiac, until he enrolled at Sac State on a scholarship in 1968. He became one of the best players in school history, averaging 19.7 points and 16 rebounds per game as a junior. Soreness in his knees cost him his senior year after only 4 games, but there was more basketball in Charlie's future. He played professionally in the Philippines for 5 seasons, and was one of 3 Americans who were the first imports to play in the Philippine Basketball Association. Charles remains a legend in the Philippines basketball community.
Inducting Charles tonight will be our head basketball coach, Andrew Jones.
Before I talk about Charles, I need to note a mistake from the video, which was a mistake I made. It said that the 1960 team went 30 and 10. That would be a really, really good year. They went 20-10, which was still a really good year. I also made a mistake in the bio. If you read his bio in the program, it says that he didn't play at Utah State. I learned from him last week that he did play, which is why I was able to get the stats that you just saw just now. You learned a bit about Charles from the video, but there are a few things that need to be emphasized or explained. When I first read about him in the old Sac City newspapers, it was clear what a great player he was, how he led the team in scoring in 27 of their 30 games, how he scored in double figures in every game except one, which they still won. But after researching the career beyond Sac City, it became clear to me that he was the first great modern player at Sac City, the first post player who played like big men do today. He could run, he could jump, he had timing, he was skilled, and boy, could he rebound. I love finding the pictures from Sac State, especially the one of him shooting the jumper with a hand in his face. The extension, the elevation, beautiful jumper. It was interesting that that picture was taken in the game where Sac State upset the league champion, SF State. And here's the quote from the school paper there that year, or that game. With the game tied at 60, Reed tried a short banker and missed. Walker grabbed the rebound and missed another short banker. Grabbed his own rebound, missed his second try. Grabbed his own rebound again and tipped the ball through just ahead of the final buzzer. I can picture him in my mind's eye, the sweat, the bodies bouncing off him, the effort, the timing, and the toughness. That tells you some things about Charles beyond skill. He competed, he was relentless, and he was a clutch player. You heard on the video that Charles holds a Sac City school record for rebounds in a game. What you probably don't know is that on January 26, 1960, he had the first 20 rebound game in school history when he grabbed exactly 20 to go along with 29 points in a win at Santa Rosa. 3 days later, he set the current school record when he had the 29 rebounds to go along with 24 points in a win at San Mateo. I wish records existed somewhere that included his rebounding totals for that season. I suspect it would be at or near the top of our current list. But what I really wish is that I had a player like Charles playing for me next season. I would even order a number 33 jersey for him to wear. In the video, it also said that Charles was all-tournament in both tournaments that the team played in that season. But what you don't learn is that one of those tournaments was the Modesto tournament. At that time, this was the best tournament in the state. It included 8 top teams from the South and 8 from the North. And Charles was one of 5 players voted to the all-tournament team. I don't know if they had an all-state team back then, but by being all-tournament at Modesto, we can safely assume that Charles was one of the top players in the state. I had the privilege last Thursday to have lunch with Charles and Catherine at their home. We had pizza and it was really good. And I got to learn more about his life, and it's been quite a life, and I'm honored to stand here and present him to you tonight. But the last word about Charles will come from Jerry Anderson, his Sac City coach back in 1960. When asked about Charles, he said simply, "I haven't seen anyone better." Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in calling to the podium the Whale, Mr. Charles Walker.
Sounds like it's about me. The truth is, it's about the people I played with. I don't know about y'all, but there was a time when it was for the love of the game, not numbers or whether you're going to lose it or how many. We just loved the players. And it didn't make any difference who was on the court. And I have some people here that not only from the fifth grade on taught me what a basketball was, but how to spell it. And even beyond that, there are people who are sitting here who we grew up together, say from kindergarten, and we played together in parks. Even across the street from the elementary school that we went to was a place called Lincoln Christian Center. And we would go there, not to practice, but we loved to play the game. And I'm standing here representing all of us at that time, even today, all of us who loved to play the game. There was a group of guys that got together. We called ourselves Mike Salt the Pontiac. Played in the March of Dames and March of Dimes, and there's no telling how many championships we won. We didn't get paid a dime just because we cared and loved one another, but it was the game that brought us together. So to stand here and accept this is way beyond me. Because you see, I know it was about us. And I wish I could have them all stand here with me and accept this. My family is here. My close relationships are here. And there's another person that's here. And I'm going to ask her to stand up. Because you see, I also know that I'm standing here because she said, "You can." And it's been the best ever since. They contacted me some 16 years ago, and she mentioned it to me. And I said to her, "You got to be kidding. Somebody's playing a game." Well, at that time, 16 years back, we went to Hawaii, and we got married. And you're talking about a Hall of Fame. See, I've been living the Hall of Fame for the past 16 years. Kathy, would you please stand? You're talking about winning? Honey, I love you. Thank you.